Hello everyone, dear students. In the previous videos of HTML, we came to know almost all about the basic and fundamentals of HTML. From this video, since here we will know some advanced level of HTML. So that is why this is HTML second part first. So what is special and what is advanced is there in this video. We are just going to start. So first of all, inserting images. As soon as this term is seen by you, then you say that we have known about it, inserting image, in the previous videos. But images can be inserted in two ways. The one is in background and the other is in foreground. In the previous videos, I have taught you about how to insert images in the background. But in this video, I am going to tell you how to insert images in the foreground. So let's start. Browser can display image files in your document if they are either GIF or XBM format. GIF is an animated format of images, and this is extension name. GIF and XBM is bitmap format. Many browsers also support images stored in JPEG format. Some browsers do not support GIF and XBM, and some browsers do not support JPEG or JPG file format. So you have to look at it. Suppose you have created an HTML document in which you have inserted an image file that is JPEG, but that JPEG file is not shown in the result in Google Chrome or you may Mozilla Firefox, then you have to open Internet Explorer, because Internet Explorer support most of the file format extension. It is easy to put a picture in your document using the IMG SRC. IMG is a tag and SRC is an attribute of IMG tag. Followed by an discode means the path of the image should be given in a proper format, and that is this, inverted commas, and the name of the file surrounded by quotes. The main tag is IMG, as I have told you, which has different attributes for different purposes, like the SRC attribute. SRC attribute specifically is used to insert an image in your web page, in your web page and in foreground, not in background. It must be kept in your mind. This attribute is used to specify the image source, the location from which the image is to be taken. You have to give that. Next, we are going to take, you know, a coded example. This is the code, the coded example. You can see inserting image body. These are the fundamental tags, as I have told you, we have to use while we create any HTML document. A very good morning, dear student. This is an HTML document created to explain you how to insert images. Then a P paragraph, P for paragraph. Now let us insert it. This is a path image from here. You can see from here, this is path image, and you have to give it clear. If any mistake is there, then definitely the browser won't be able to understand and can't access the image you want to insert in it. This picture is being displayed in the browser. Now we will see the result. What is the result actually? The result of the previous coding is shown below. This is the, you know, you can see. First of all, we have written down some text, and this text is given over here. And then we have given the path of the image, and so the image is there before you. I am going to, you know, make another video for making you learn. In means tutorial video, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to give you for this, and in which we will I will teach you how to insert not only this image but also some other images. I'll show you on tutorial video how you can and how you will give the path of the, you know, the location of the file, the location of the photo you want to insert. So this was all about how to insert an image, and something more about how to insert, not only insert, how to align it and how to increase or decrease the size of it, this was known. So this will be known in the further video. Thank you and have a nice day.